In our last class, we learned the characteristics of living beings. Today, in this class, we are going to learn the remaining character, that is, living beings respond to stimulus and living beings have lifespan. Before starting the class, what do you mean by stimulus? Living beings respond to stimulus. What do you mean by stimulus? Stimulus means respond. What kind of respond? Let's see. Respond to touch, heat, cold, sound, and smell.
Yeah.
sensory organ. What we call? Skin, ear, nose are sensory organs which helps to respond or which helps to stimulus towards nature or atmosphere. Okay. Is human beings only respond in nature? Let's see. Human beings are living beings, so human beings respond towards nature either by touching, by heat, cold, sound and smell. In this same way, animals also respond. Because animals are so living beings, so animals also respond to the. If the buffalo feel hot, what they can? They dip in water to maintain their body temperature. This is also respond. Okay, next, when external things touching to scorpion, it starts stinging. The stinging is also one kind of response. Bites us, we are immediately respond by scrubbing or by applying some ointments, we are respond to bite of animals. In the same way, some ants also bite to us. Everyone can get bite by ants. How we respond? We are scrubbing or we are applying some ointments to that pain. So, we are responding in our atmosphere or in nature. Animals also respond in the same way how the human beings respond in nature. Is only response takes place in human beings and animals only? What about plants? Plants also respond.
Birth and death, we call as lifespan. Lifespan is the period between birth and death, we call as lifespan. Okay, baby born, it starts growing. Okay, if the baby starts growing and reaches certain age, the baby becomes dead. The period between birth and death we call as lifespan. For example, commonly human beings live for 60 years. Okay, 60 years is the common age for living as human beings. In the same way, if the person is born and start growing at certain age, the person becomes dead. Means the difference between birth and The radish, then sugar cane, cabbage, ginger, beetroot. These are the example for biennial plants. Next, we move on the another types of plants, that is perennial. Perennial is here more than two, we call as perennial. In mathematics, we learn biennial is two. Next, three is tri. Here there is no tri or whatever, but the next group is perennial plants. Let's move on. Next types of plants, that is perennial. Next is perennial. What do you mean by perennial plants? Perennial means plants live for many years and produce fruits, flowers and seeds continuously. We call that perennial plants. Plants live for many years means either the lifespan may be 5 years, 10 years, whatever, but more than 2 years. Okay, more than 2 years of lifespan of plants we call that perennial plant. The definition of perennial plants is plants live for many years and give us fruits, flowers and seeds. We call as perennial plant. Perennial plants means example for perennial plants are coconut trees, mango, lemon and knee, jackfruit, areca. These are the examples for perennial plants. Okay, see students, on the basis of living beings' lifespan, plants are classified into three types: annuals, biennials, and perennials. Annual plants' lifespan is only 1 year or one season. Biennials' lifespan is 2 years or two seasons. Perennial lifespan is more than 2 seasons or 2 years. We call that perennial plants. These are all about living beings of lifespan. See students, in the topic living world, we learn what you mean by living beings and what you mean by non-living beings. The things are the organism which grow, move and breathe we call as living beings. The organism which are not grow, breathe and move we call as non-living beings. Here is the characteristics of living beings. First one is living beings are made up of cells. Cells means human beings also made up of cells, animals also made up of cells, plants also made up of cells.
prepare food with the help of photosynthesis process. Okay, sun is the main source. We eat food for growth, maintain our body and for energy. Next one is living beings grow. We saw how living beings grow.
Wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries.